Hello everyone. Today's video I will guide you step by step how to make a battery cell welding machine that is simple and easy to use with readily available materials that are easy to find. Use a 12-volt 6-amp battery, and the most important thing is the relay. As shown on the screen, it is taken from the motorcycle starter relay. You can reuse it or buy a new one at a motorcycle repair shop. It's really durable and responsive, and it's also cheap, estimated at around $2 or more depending on the country it's sold in. The third indispensable thing is the handle to solder zinc to the battery cell. You can make one like mine or with two copper rods, as long as it is insulated and can be held while operating to avoid burning your hands. Next is the power cable. You need to use high resistance wire, and here I use 2.5 millimeters copper core. And small electric cable to connect the on-off switch relay. Let's explore a little bit this battery cell welding handle. I designed and created it myself using natural materials. Two copper bars and a hard white plastic that can withstand high temperatures. The downside is that it is very fragile if dropped from a height of 1 meter to the ground. Nothing special, right? You can make it from wood as long as it doesn't short circuit and is heat resistant. Now I assemble them and add an outer shell for aesthetics. It has a black plastic case that looks sturdy. Now I'll connect the power cord here first. In this part, I will make a control switch for the relay, and also introduce a little bit about this soldering iron. I have recorded a video tutorial on how to make it and posted it in the previous video. If you have not seen it, after watching this video, please come back to the channel to see me make the soldering iron as above. I use this type of switch, the resistance seems a bit small. If anyone has the same opinion as me, please let me know your opinion in the comment section below. I will attach the switch to the handle in this area so that when pressing it, it will be more convenient and easier. I will connect the red power cable to the relay and the other end I connect to the positive plus source of the battery. Connect the white power source with a relay control wire to the negative terminal of the battery. You should tighten all the connectors because the current passing through here is quite high and will cause heat. So the connection is done. Let's take a look at this wonderful work again. So that you don't have to wait long, let's now practice testing it and see what the results are. The distance between the two soldering irons, I find, is quite standard compared to the old solder of this battery. If the video is good, please give me a like, a comment, and a channel subscription to support me to have more motivation to make the next videos. Thank you very much. Overall assessment of this welding device. As you can see, the weld is very nice. The zinc sticks tightly to the battery cell, although not as good as a professional welding machine, but for me it is to standard. And because I have never welded this type of battery cell before, I have no experience. I will try a few more welds to see how it goes. I've gotten used to welding and it's much better now. All the welds have been firmly attached to the surface of the battery cell. It's really effective, isn't it, everyone? Thank you for watching. If the video is good and meaningful, please give this tip for you DIY channel a like and a channel subscription so that the channel has more motivation to make the next videos on similar topics to send to everyone. Thank you very much.